I'm just here not to be seen or heard.
Dale. Dale is the lord of all games. Bow before Dale. Sean from Blue Table Painting has nothing on you. Huh? Exactly. Who does? So, Justin.
Yes.
Is going to be my opponent tonight. He's going to be rocking some
Eldar and Dark Eldar. Yeah.
Yes.
Do you want me to explain this?
We're going to go into exactly what's in there in just a second. But I have to do the standard, like hold it up so my chin looks skinny. So this is Sean from Cool Guys Nation. And we're going to play some Warhammer 40K tonight. And we're looking at Eldar, Dark Eldar versus Dark Angel. So there's a lot of darkness going on, which is excellent. And we're going to run down the army lists real quick. And then we're going to look at what we're playing. I think we're going to do a Nova mission this evening. So should be cool and very, very different. So stay tuned.
Yeah, whenever you want me to do.
All right, man. Well, yeah, so we are we're rolling. So Justin's going to go ahead and run down the list he's playing today. So we're 1850 points, I believe.
Yes. Great.
Okay.
So I have an Eldar combined arms attachment. I've got my Farseer on jet bike. He has the Spirit Stones, which let him cast a power at -1 warp charge.
Nice.
I have the Autarch on jet bike. He has a laser lance. And he has the Banshee Mask, so no Overwatch for against this unit.
Awesome.
Two units of Scatter Laser Jet Bikes. They're also Wizards. what else I got for the Eldar? I got a unit of Swooping Hawks with their X-Arch. I got three units of Dark Reapers, three in each squad with an X-Arch. And then I have a Aspectos attachment, so seven Warp Spiders with an X-Arch, seven Warp Spiders with an X-Arch. Five Fire Dragons with an X-Arch. For Dark Eldar, I have the Lamian, so just cheap 10-point HQ.
Okay.
Two units of five Warriors in Venom, dual Splinter Cannons. I got a unit of Scourges, Haywire Blasters, Reaver Jet Bikes, Cluster Caltrops, and another Venom for the Fire Dragons to boost in, a Bastion, and three little Mandrakes. So, yeah.
Solid, man. Solid. I don't know what any of that means, because I haven't played Dark Eldar, or Eldar, for that matter, since, like, 5th edition. Go randomness. So it's gonna be an interesting trial by fire.
All right.
Yeah, good stuff.
Forces of the Grimdark ship pit.
I don't know what that means, Dale, but I'm gonna pick up my beer and drink to it. Cause that's what I do. All right. So over on the Dark Angel side, those are not Dark Angel's aircraft, are they? Anywho, so what we're looking at is we've got Company Master, Relic Blade, Auspex, Melt Bombs, and a Storm Shield. So he's cool. He's going to be rocking with a Assault Squad. I should probably tell you what this is. So this is two Dark Angel companies. A little teeny tiny scout detachment back there from the 10th Company. And then we're going to be running the Storm Wing. From the Space Marines Codex. We'll go ahead and talk about Dark Angels. So there's two six-man assault squads, two flamers in each. And these are these guys right here in the front. Each commander has veteran, so +1 attack. We're looking at power swords on both, melt-a-bombs on both. That company master right there is, again, Relic Blade. What did I say? Melt-a-bomb, Auspex, and Artificer Armor, as well as the Storm Shield, so he's gonna be kinda, you know, rocking it. I got a Chaplain, just basic Chappy, but he does have a Plasma Pistol on him. There are six separate squads, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of TAC Marines, 5 TAC Marines each, with just a Plasma Rifle in there. We got a Devastator Squad with Plasma Cannons, another Devastator Squad with Las Cannons. There's that 5-man Sniper Squad, nothing special in there except for the Sniper Rifles. I don't know if they have camo cloaks. I'm going to have to look and see if I can find a list because I don't remember. Aircraft-wise, we're looking at the Storm Raven with Las Cannons and a Multimelta. The Storm Talons each have the fancy Skyhammer missile launchers and assault cannon. We have a drop pod, which is actually assigned to one of my assault squads. We have six transport things, three last class Razorbacks, each for attack squad, and then two Rhinos each for attack squad. So I have one attack squad on foot at the end of the day. And that should pretty much, that'll be the 1850 for the Dark Angels. I couldn't figure out how to fit the Centurions and the Selects. Would have needed like, you know, 2,500 points for all that, but next time. And so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna look at the mission. So Justin actually already rolled up the mission off camera, and we're doing number 2 out of the Nova Open. Let me turn this around and look at myself because it's fun. So, do you want to? Can I hold this camera here and have you kind of just tell us what's going on with this mission? Because it's going to be a little complicated, right?
So, for those unfamiliar with the Nova missions, this year and I guess sort of last year, they sort of let you pick. So, in this mission, it's the scouring. Each player has 3 objectives. They place 2 in their deployment zone, 1 in their table half. They'll be worth randomly 3, 2, and 1 points.
And we're going to roll that at objective placement or after we put them all down?
I believe we roll that before Seize the Initiative.
Okay, solid.
Right before the game starts.
Excellent,
Value. So there's basically 2 ways you can go about this. One is you can try and get points based on the number of points you control at the end of the game, based on the objectives you're controlling, a max value of 9. The other is from turns 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, starting at the beginning of the turn, you accumulate points based on what objectives you're controlling. So if you're controlling 3 total points worth of objectives plus 1 point, 5 plus 1, and 7 is plus 1. So the most you can get in a turn is 3 points. You're controlling 7
okay.
total points of objectives, and again, that caps out at 9. The other thing is Nova has a bunch of good little list of secondary mission pools, so we'll each be selecting a bunch of different things. So it's not, there are Slay the Warlord, First Blood, and Linebreaker, but also a bunch of different things like Last Blood, Heart of the Matter, where your Warlord's at the center. So I guess we can explain those choices once.
Yeah,
I
figure we'll probably go ahead and decide what we want to play, you know, what we want to pick out of the list, and then we'll go over exactly what they do before we start rolling for it.
So,
and I assume that we pick all that mission stuff before we do warlord traits, psychic powers, any of that stuff, correct?
In secret we
okay,
do this, so
cool.
Yeah.
Well, so we're gonna go ahead and do that now, and we'll be back when we know what's happening. Okay. So now that we have selected our Nova objectives, we selected 1 primary and 3 secondary objectives, I believe. Would you like to go first?
Sure. So I picked the primary, the gambler, which is basically end game points. I can get up to 9 at the end of the game because I'm a little kind of fast skirt.
Yeah, good choice.
Army. Secondary, I pick Mark for Death, so I pick one of your units that I want to kill. Linebreaker, pretty standard stuff. Moment of Bloodshed, I have to kill 3 or more units in 1 single turn.
Solid. All good choices for a fast Eldar army. All good choices. So I went ahead and my primary is the progressive objectives with the objectives secured and the slow vehicles. I'm going to be trying to get those while we go. I'm going to do First Blood for one of my secondaries, the Momentum of Blood as well, because I like the small unit size you got going on over there, so I'm hoping I can capitalize on that. And endgame kill points for the 2 secondaries. So hopefully that should line up pretty good. So then we're gonna go on to rolling for warlord traits and psychic powers and all that good stuff.
Yeah. We can do warlord traits
okay.
First, I guess.
Yeah, and I'm gonna do, this guy, what do I want to do? You know what? I'm going to go like straight out of the book, and my company master is going to be rocking the Dark Angels book. So I'm just going to throw dice, and we're going to see what I get. And because I have the demi companies and all that good stuff, I'll get to reroll it. So I got a 3. So let's go over here. I'm glad I didn't grab my old 6th edition book, because that would have sucked.
I'm Justin Devon. Nice to meet you. It's me. I play Space Wolves.
Oh, very cool. This guy's a good time. For the Lion, your Warlord and his unit have the Furious Charge special rule, which I will keep.
Okay. I'm going to roll Strategic, also known as the Good One.
Hell yeah, man.
So it's on the Autark. Units have moved their cover, ruins, stealth ruins. I suppose the question before I decide on this, what are we going to call the board? This is always a challenge with 40K.
Yep. So the only things that I would say, so I would consider this impassable.
Okay.
You know, being up on it, you know, down here, it's always, I think we're looking at rocks for everything. You know, like if we wanted to call
sort of
that
like,
ruins.
Like a battlescape, so area terrain, you get a five up cover safety.
Exactly.
Toe tapping.
Exactly.
Okay. So if since we're not calling anything ruins, then I'll probably re-roll that.
Yeah.
Three, which is Warlord, and three non-vehicle units have infiltrated.
That's my favorite.
Yes.
That's my favorite. What's that one called?
Master of Ambush.
Master of Ambush. So we will be looking at some ambushes.
Psychic powers?
I have no psychic powers this game.
Yeah. Okay. I do. So my Farseer, I'll pop the first roll on telepathy. One, I don't think that's very good from what I remember. No, Dominate. That's not horrible versus you. I'm just going to swap it for Psychic Shrink. I'll roll one more time up on telepathy.
Now, okay, so you're going to split them. You know that if you roll everything on the same discipline, you get the primaries. Okay, cool.
Terrified? Okay.
Oh, over there.
I've been doing a lot of newbie training, so I apologize for anything silly that I try to inform you of that you already know.
That's okay.
1850.
Elder on table. One, I'm just going to take guide.
Okay, solid.
Alrighty.
Do you have any more psychers that we need to deal with?
Just the Farseer.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
cool.
Alright, so, roll for good old table size.
Yes, sir.
Now
we'll get table size. I think I'm going to take this side.
Okay, and I guess we take turns then placing our objectives. So okay. You have to be in your table side of Hammer and Anvil. One can be, has to be 30 inches up, but also in your table.
So that one is going to probably let you place your objectives first.
Oh, okay.
Solid. So you're going to...
So I'm on this side?
Yep. So this is the question. So the way I figured it was I would prefer to have you out in the open jumping around to wherever you want to as opposed to in nice line of sight block and cover jumping around to wherever you want to. All right. And that'll be my first one. Parallels. So you got two in the backfield, two in the backfield.
And then my third one, which has to be at least...
Oh, it's got to be my deployment zone, right?
Yeah, so I think as long as you're 24 inches up, you might have been okay. So the third one has to be at least 30 inches up, and it has, it's still on the table now, so let's see. It forces a little bit of action here.
Yeah.
Although I can't do it.
I love it, Justin. I love it. And we're going to go right there. So we've got an objective back here behind, on top of the back of this rock. And one right there, kind of hidden back by these guys. And then my three are going to be in a nice little triangle right here, which should hopefully give us a good chance to hold down the fort against these super, super mobile Eldar.
Night fight. Do you want to roll?
No, go ahead, man. All
right. It is not night
fight. It is not night fight.
Okay. Deployment. So, standard roll here.
And I will deploy first. Cool. So, this is Sean. I rolled up first turn. I went ahead and deployed over here pretty strong. So what we're looking at is attack squads inside of each of the vehicles on the field. I got a dev squad right there with plasma cannons. Their whole job is going to be to run up and get a line of fire somewhere or fall back. I don't know what the hell I'm going to do with them. But they didn't really have any good line of sight cover options. Devs with blast cannons back in that building right there. We've got scouts with sniper rifles infiltrating, and the storm wing is going to come on separately. I have an assault squad inside of the drop pod, and then we're looking at an assault squad with the two characters inside of the storm raven itself. So we're going to let Justin go ahead and set up and see what happens.
And I guess we got to roll for the values of each one of our things.
Yeah. Well, deployment real quick. Devin, get out of the way. Jesus. So These are Dark Reapers. So three squads of Dark Reapers back holding this objective.
Farseer, Autark, and Reaver jet bikes all deployed as one unit back there.
Okay.
And okay. The Bastion, yeah. The rest of my stuff coming in from reserves, either Deep Strike or Boardage.
Okay. And these are the guys with the 36-inch poison 4?
No, that's the vehicles, the Vandals.
What are these guys shooting?
They shoot a single rapid-fire splinter shot if they if they can.
So just, cool. Yeah. All right, man. So, yeah, we got to go ahead and determine what the values of some of these.
On a 1-2, it'll be worth 1. 3-4 is 2. 5-6 is 3.
Sounds good.
So this one is worth 3.
Well, that was lucky.
1-2-3, it's worth 1. 4-5-6 is worth 2. So it's 3-1-2.
Do you just want to set like a dice on them?
Yeah,
a die on them?
Okay. I have these, I don't use them.
Solid, man.
Yeah.
All right, so I'll do the same thing. So this guy right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. And so this guy will be the 3. This guy underneath the Rhino. First half will be the short ones. This will be 2, and then this guy will be 1.
Awesome. 3. This one is 2 over here.
Yep.
Oh, it's like under this.
Yeah, so you just want to set that somewhere. It'll be cool.
And that's
one. And then 1 for this guy.
Awesome. Well, would you like first turn or second turn, seeing as you deploy first?
I think I'm going to take second turn.
Good choice. All right. Well, let's do it too.
Absolutely. Absolutely, man. Justin, good luck.
You too.
All right. Drink some beer.
Sounds good. Never a bad plan.
So movement phase. Well, psychic.
Right?
Movement.
Psychic
movement phase. Yeah. Beer.
Yeah.
What can I say? I do think that was the solid choice, man. Because now you gotta do something. Now you have to pick.
No, I mean, I think going second's always a nice move there. They're gonna try and embark into the Bastion here, this unit here. So I guess they're going through terrain. 3 inches should bring them within 6 of the hatch. So this unit's a side.
So 6 of the hatch now, not 2. Because if the access point's like vehicles, 2 inches, right?
It's 6.
Yeah, but you're still, I mean, you made it on 3 inches, no stress.
6 disembark, 2 or 2 to get it.
I'm really hoping that they win that.
These guys will jump up onto the rock or attempt to at least.
I think they're going to succeed at that. These guys are slow and purposeful, so they can't run, but they're relentless. And that's pretty much it, right? No sweeping advance, maybe?
No sweeping advance. I don't think they're going to win many combats, but yeah.
Yeah, no worries. That's not what they're there for.
Other unit will try and get up there, see what they got.
So no vertical distance anymore? Because you remember back in, like, 5th and 6th, and it's a contentious point, but that's, battle reports and all that good stuff.
That is something worth discussing. And it's probably something we should have talked about before.
Yeah, no worries.
Generally, in Nova, you kind of just...
Yeah, because I know like my jetpack infantry with my Tau, we ignore all that stuff. And I know that the Swooping Hawks, there's been like some stuff where, you moved over it, there's no vertical distance, so I moved over your aircraft and
so
can, vector strike it or whatever. They got some stuff like that going on.
Right, in Nova, a lot of times it's ruins, moving up and down. Other stuff is just you move, right? So
cool.
Yeah, for the area terrain, I was just moving.
I like it. No, as long as we're all on the same page, man. As long as we're all on the same page. So cool. And I like that because, again, ruins have kind of this structure to them. I really wish they wouldn't have removed area terrain because I like bases. It simplifies things. There's no questions. There's no, or have just decided one way or the other and not like left it ambiguous.
It does make it a bit easier. So that's pretty cool.
So look from the Dark Angels line. I wish I had more las cannons over on this side of the world. There's a blob of some scariness back behind that little pumping station. which I guess is the only reason we're here, because I'm not fighting over a bell tower.
Yeah.
So. The Autarchs, the Farseer, are going to shuffle a little bit back behind the water reservoir. And on.
Anything? No, it's
two dice! Awesome. Just what I wanted.
I'll go ahead and guide that unit, so it basically twin links them. Okay. I need one warp dice to successfully cast it. I'll throw three at it.
Okay. We'll get one.
I'll use the Farseer's runes to reroll these.
Solid.
Yeah, still goes off.
So still just one, so I mean I'm gonna throw my dice at it and no bueno, so they're guided.
Alrighty. So shooting phase. Let's go ahead and see if we can do anything with these rhinos. And they're all the same unit. So let's start with the guys in the Bastion on that rhino.
On the Razorback?
Razorback.
Solid. No worries, no worries. Wait till I get my other six.
Yeah, yeah. So X-Arch, normal two guys, they're all strength five. X-Arch needs twos to hit, the others need threes. All right, I need five glints.
Strength
sixes.
Five?
Yeah.
Six glints, yep.
Nothing.
Right. Go armor value 11. Yay.
Yeah, seriously.
it's like having 25 strength 10 AP 2 attacks.
They're going to hit the same. I'm going to go in here.
We're going to lose that down, man.
On the rhino? Okay. And this is from the
Twin Links.
Oh, the Twin Link guys.
Yeah.
Twin Link guys.
Same thing here. Let's see if the Twin Links can help out a little bit.
I hope so.
All right. Sixes again, yeah.
Oh, three will wreck out a rhino, which is unfortunate. That's okay. That's what I didn't pay any points for that.
Yeah, seriously.
So we'll go ahead and do. But you're gonna shoot a whole bunch of dice at me. You're gonna hit me and wound me a bunch of times.
They're all right at killing Marines. They certainly rather shoot Marines than Razorbacks. It's a bit
there we go, that's the dude. Okay. So yeah, that guy's...
They're good.
That guy's smoked out.
Check for them.
Eight. Whatever it is, they're going to be fine.
So I should have these two against these two. I'm just going to go ahead and do it.
Okay.
So X-Arch and the one guy against your two guys I can't actually see, so I guess whatever he is.
Yep.
The plasma gun.
Bolter dude and the plasma gun.
So hits. I need threes.
Twos.
And you would definitely get two.
But these are, what's the AP on these guys?
AP 3.
Ah.
So yeah, if you be behind that thing, you'll get 5 up.
Yep. So 5 up. So 5 up. Solid. Way to duck the opening shots. You should see me with my Terminators.
Yeah.
It's stupid.
That's pretty good. So otherwise, I just turbo boost these a little bit. Just to make sure I didn't do anything I don't necessarily want to do. Here. All right, that'll be end of turn one for me.
Okay. So, shooting phase. Bloody recording.
I'll bring both spiders in.
All right, man, dude. Thanks for dropping by, bro.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we'll be in touch.
Yeah, nice meeting.
What's
yeah.
up?
Justin.
Forums, play games, kill each other. It's the best.
Yeah, totally. Swooping Hawks. Do you want to bring him in?
Yeah, bring him in.
Everybody.
Scourges.
Yeah, the volume of deep striking stuff is not good for me.
Warriors coming in. Fire dragons coming in.
All right, deep strike mishaps. Everyone, everywhere, deep strike mishaps.
It does happen. And then what else I got here? I got the 2 units of Eldar jet bikes coming on board edge, 1 in, 1 out. I have the mandrakes. They have to come in. Unfortunately, the Lamian has to come in. So, everything but one.
But they're not like the Vipers aren't a squad. They're three separate
three
units,
separate
right?
Things with so. A unit in
them. Gotcha. Yeah, so this is going to be interesting. So you got a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units or so? A lot of units coming in off of the either deep strike or board edge this turn. So, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what the tactical situation is. Hopefully we're in a pretty defensible position around these four objectives. We're just going to have to see.
Spiders.
Strength 6, right?
Yes. Bring them in.
I'll take it. Space Marine, baby. We jammed the EW waves like no one knows. I don't know if they're EW waves, but you get the idea.
Spiders in.
Oh, I saw the little... I totally thought you scattered 9 inches. I misread your die. Yep. Yep. And you said his blast template is
20 points? They have 4 haywire blasters, so it's a 20. They each have 1 shot.
Oh, so these are the Dark Angel guys.
These are
or the Dark Eldar guys. So then the Swooping Hawks are the ones who did not come in?
They are coming in.
Oh, they are coming in. Hey, everybody's coming in, man.
So these guys are going up. It looks like they are going to have to take dangerous terrain.
That's cool.
Terrain. That is
Yeah, man, one of my secret tacks for the Tau is the EMP grenades.
Yeah, they're pretty
six.
Nice.
Six-man squads of Pathfinders, Fire Warriors, whatever, EMP grenades, walking.
Yeah. Ooh, 2 armor saves, okay. I like sails,
just one.
Pain, 6 up.
One toast.
So one of my little haywires.
Now, let me ask you a question, Mr. I've been to ATC. How do you deal with random allocation of wounds? Not to be like snarky or anything.
Should have randomized it. I guess
no, I'm just
for
wondering.
The sake of time, which is not. But yeah, you can just assign 1, 2, 3, 4. In this situation, I just think.
No, and I do the same thing, man. I don't even, I literally disregard random allocation.
I don't even,
unless it is a very important component, you know, and then we sit down and crunch the numbers and roll the dice, and it takes us 5 minutes. But like something like this, I mean, I'm absolutely with you. Who
cares?
Yeah,
it's not a huge thing, especially because they're in range to what they need.
Yeah, and I know that some people would be like, oh, well, you know, what if your sergeant died? What if your guy with the special weapon, you know?
I did do the special weapon separate than the sergeant.
Okay, solid.
So I did roll for who took the haywire hit.
So there's a good...
And so a haywire guy did die. So I rolled the special weapon separate from the sergeant.
Okay.
However, which one of the haywire identical guys...
Gotcha.
Died.
So is it more along the lines of you're looking at, you know, when I roll my dice to see who's affected, I'm separating those out by special weapons?
Yeah,
you know, like,
yeah.
Not so much, oh, what do I do with the save, but what do I do with the initial who failed
who
the test?
Actually, which one of the identical guys died in this case isn't super relevant.
Gotcha.
Sometimes it can be. Just figure, you know, for the sake of time.
No, I was just wondering, because, you know,
it's a good question.
You want to know the funniest thing ever, man? You know the Raven Wing shenanigans where there's no HQs that have Raven Wings in the Dark Angels book?
Yeah, yeah.
So I wrote GW an email and was like, hey, what's the word with this? How does it work? What's going on? They were like, talk to your local gaming group and decide for yourself. Like,
ATC
literally, that was their official email.
ATC allowed the...
You kind of have to, as long as you take a bike. I would tie it to a bike and say, as long as he's on a bike, Raven Wing.
I think like, this is probably their intent.
Yeah.
But that was probably their intent, I think.
Agreed.
So they'll disembark. Because if not, it's just such a bug. I mean, you're like, you know... It's so clearly obvious that you don't have to take Samio every time.
Well, and you know, there's three HQ slots in their formation. Like, it's just...
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah, I mean...
Permissive.
That would be...
In this case.
It would be so ridiculous not to...
All right, man, so Eldar are just showing up everywhere from the fucking Webway, man.
They are.
Space, the Webway, the Board Edge, you name it. Geometry kids, any of you in sixth grade who have the opportunity to take geometry, do it. Also, like your parallax, a lot of people are really, really bad at the angle that they pull off of their scatter die.
I think what you have to do is roll it close. Because it's so many people roll it far away from what they're they're deep striking, and
yep.
Then you get into like, well, was it that, or was it like something completely not that? And
yeah, yep.
It's a lot to deal with all that. So, what else I got to deep strike? These guys, I don't know why it's necessarily even bothering to deep strike. I think there's a lot of stuff right here. We're trying to keep striking these warriors. I should have just brought them off the board edge with these two warriors feeders. But you get when you haven't played the army in a little while.
No, I understand, man. I'm still in complete discovery mode on this Lionblade task force, so.
Let's bring him in here, because I think this is where they can be. Six.
You have to see my first
unit. And the other unit of them.
The backfield is filling up with a lot of Eldar.
It's alright, so then the Swooping Hog is dope scatter, which is quite nice. Because after dealing with all that, it's a
yep.
little easier not to have to deal with.
For reals, guys. For reals. For reals. Always heard the Eldar were tricksy. Clearly, it was true.
And then I got some board edge stuff.
Five.
So stuff in action.
So you get to flat out 12 or 18 with the jet bikes?
The jet bikes can flat out 36 inches.
Wow.
Eldar jet bikes are what they call ridiculous. So yeah, they can go quite far.
Fun.
Yeah, they're a little ridiculous, they're a little sleazy, but...
There's not too many of them, you know, today.
I'll be okay. This army isn't the, like, mass boogeyman jet bike army that people were kind of talking about. Like, Sky is Falling.
Yeah. I have yet to see anything The Sky is Falling. But I've seen some scary stuff.
It is pretty extreme.
I've had my face kicked in.
Yeah. The game's extreme, but certainly playable.
Yeah.
So, end of the movement phase. I drop the bomb from the Hawks, and we're going to drop it on the little five-man right here.
Okay.
That way, five.
Use my tape measure, man. That's all good. Just so long as you don't hit everyone.
Two.
Okay.
Four, straight four, and one move.
All right. Anything special in the ways of AP?
AP 4, ignores cover, it doesn't matter.
Probably good on a 5.
Does he regroup? He does, barely on 9. So he can rally 3 inches, he can snap fire, that's pretty much his life. So,
So now the rest of the movement phase, right? If you so choose to move.
That's right. Well, that's true. Does anything really need to move, want to move? Kind of.
Oh, I wonder if I'm going to get shot by every single unit in your army this turn.
So they're all good. Let's do Johnson Racers up there. I just move up a little bit. So, psychic phase.
One. Okay, one dice. Let's use a white die. Maybe that'll be a 6 when I roll it.
I will throw 2. Do they have a veteran sergeant or just a sergeant?
They do have
a veteran sergeant. Okay.
Power sword, veteran sergeant, melt the bomb.
That's cool. I'm going to throw 2 with guide on that unit.
Okay.
It fails. I'll pop the stones to reroll it this turn. To pass on one.
What other psychic powers do you know?
Shriek and terrify.
Shriek and terrify. I'm going to throw my one die at the guide.
Okay.
Because if I get a 6.
Totally.
Nope.
Okay.
But it was worth it.
Do I want to throw 2 at shrieks? Or do I want to just try and shriek them? I'm just going to try and shriek them because I don't think I'll get both powers off. So I'll throw 2 at shriek on that unit. It passes, but just barely. Does it hit? I need a 2 or higher. It does hit, so yeah, you can hit.
Ouch. So everybody's dead.
Who can it see? It only can see these 3 here.
Really?
From the far seat?
Well, I will take that as a boon, my friend.
Still is a shooting attack. I mean,
still is a shooting attack. Yeah.
So
way to survive 2 6s and a 5, assault squad.
They did
what the hell? Play.
So at the end of the psychic phase, they will have to take a morale check because they lost.
And are you done with your psychic phase? Obviously, because you have no more dice.
No more dice.
And they will fail.
They're falling back.
On 2 6s, and they will run 3 inches.
So they still have.
Something like that.
All right. So let's start with Haywire on that.
Okay.
So 3 shots against that. Razorback sitting there.
I feel like I'm about to get taken apart. Just a little bit.
We'll see what we can do. 3 hits.
Okay. Just don't roll those for the Haywire.
So 2 glances.
And Razorback will be down to 1. Unless you think I'll get a 5-up cover from rocks and shit in between us.
That's a good question. It's your call.
Oh, I will always take a 5-up cover if you let me have it.
Based on their sort of thing, you can go for it.
Nothing.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So, next up. Can shoot the Reapers in here at it.
Okay. About to lose all the tanks.
Exarch, normal guys. They all hit. I need a six. Got it, barely. So it'll pop.
And we'll go ahead and get out in standard Heidi Marine fashion. We will take a pinning test and we'll be good on a seven.
That's good.
Yeah, losing the left flank, so you know.
They'll shoot down at your guys here. So Reapers on. Reapers on bridge at falling back guys.
Every single one of them.
They need threes. They get
two.
So that balanced out. Heavily.
Yeah, I can do that. I can do that. AP three. So, I mean, so the question here is, would you at least give me cover on the first guy for being obscured?
Absolutely. Yeah, I err on the side of cover.
So five up.
Dead.
He's dead.
And then the second guy.
Yeah, so they're all toast.
Well, it was only two.
Oh, it was only two?
So one.
So we have a sergeant.
Still
oops.
You can step on this. They're a little.
Well, assault squad, I don't know if it was worth it for just two Reapers there.
Yeah.
But it did get you commit.
Well,
and you're not all over my balls the way you could be all over my balls.
So, scatter bikes will go into that good old razor right there.
Looking at the rhino, those three dudes.
Let's see if we can do anything to it.
So many shots. These are strength six, correct?
Yeah, correct, they are.
Yep, so five is a glance.
Yep.
This is not looking good. Oh, it's looking really good.
It gets one glance.
One glance.
Yeah, not bad.
And I don't think I'm going to have 25% cover. I think that rock right there might obscure it a little bit, but not enough to give them, not enough for me to feel good about taking a cover save on that. So.
Yeah, I think those guys probably not going to get it. I can't get that. Just because it doesn't matter, that guy's a bigger threat. Let's go ahead and just
Dacko.
Just shoot the fire dragons at him. Just sort of waste them, but
yeah. But what are you gonna do next turn? It's actually you're gonna move forward. You're gonna nuke the pod.
Yeah,
you
know, I mean, I have no reason.
Yeah, and if he gets into combat, he might knock out a squad.
Rolling quite a bit of ones here.
Oh, and they're all BS5 because of the detachment you took.
So three wounds, the pod
on five. It does not confer a 5-up cover save?
Pods are counted as clear.
Okay, I've played that wrong my entire life.
Yeah,
I know that it. I know that you could see through it, but I always assumed that it provided you the 5-up cover. Because I know that they're clear for line of sight.
I think you're right. Clear for line of sight.
So I'll go to the ground if you don't mind, man.
Go for it.
Or you know what? Do I want to be like super ballsy? I want to be super ballsy and see if I can roll 3 5s. I think the chances of me rolling 3 4s are pretty slim. So I'm going to try for these 3 5s just in case I can survive. And I will not get them miserably.
He is
a done assault marine. So that is that's 2-3 kill points to Justin.
Mandrix, 3. These worm spiders will go ahead and shoot at this tank.
6 guys, or 7 guys. 6 guys in an X-Arch.
There are 8 total.
Oh, yeah.
So
hidden in there among the blue.
16 shots.
Oh.
They are ballistic skill 5.
Having those 3 extra dudes is a lot of extra shots, man.
Yeah, it is. They hit
every single one.
So strength 6, they still need 5 and 6s. Let's see if we can do anything to your guys.
You will do it.
Pen, lance. It can't explode, so it just wrecks. they will run after shooting, because of battle focus, they'll wait to reroll that
6 inches. Nice. And here's going to be my pinning test. Well, I guess I should move out, but I'm going to be pinned. I'm sorry, I should have done that beforehand.
No, no worries.
Because it does matter, because now I'm going to put him behind or somewhere. But I need to hold this objective, don't I?
Yeah, I mean...
Process, man, process. Okay, yeah. These guys will be pinned, sucks. That guy's toast.
So, Fire Dragon Venom, it's got only one shot cannon on this one, because I didn't have all the points. So 6, and then 7 shots from the other slot.
Still a little bit.
Yeah, still some shots, if I can stop rolling 1s and 2s. Nothing.
Cool. I will take it. We needed that. So yeah, Rhino, Razorback, Assault Squad. I don't think I lost any Marines, but...
Yeah, this will just go ahead and... It was just flat out to get into a better position for next turn. Those have to still do something. Let's see.
So is this the same shoot run situation as before?
They can run and then shoot, or shoot and then.
Okay, cool.
So I'm gonna try and run and then shoot. Or.
Oh, because yeah, they did not knock out that Razorback. I was hoping that they were done. I had it in my brain that they were spent. All right, well, here come the Marine casualties.
So definitely some are missing out, but I would say probably this arc, maybe.
Because he can see those two, this arc can see these, this can see that. So it's probably all but two.
Okay.
Shots on the
yeah, I think that... Yeah, I think that'll work.
So they'll get 12 shots instead of their 8. So here's the 12.
Ouch.
2s to wound, 6s are monofilament. So 1 monofilament, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can take the cover first, I guess.
Okay, so here's my 5-up cover. Makes it. Sweet.
So, 8 armors.
8 armors?
Yep.
So we'll just go to, I got a plasma guy in the front, huh? 3, and a 3, and a 3. I need some more green dice.
So 5 more.
Yes, sir. This is one of my crazy neurosis things. I have to use green dice for armor and cover saves. All right. So let's see, man. Let's see. So 5 more armor saves. 3 ups. So let's get a 3 and a 5 and a 4 and a 2. 1 guy down and a 5. So 1 guy, I mean, but that'll be my plasma dude, which is kind of unfortunate. It's not bad numbers, man. Those green dice. Green dice.
All right. This Venom will go ahead and try and hit these Devastators. So let's see. Actually, I'm going to start with the guys inside snap firing their shots. So we get
okay.
5. I hit 1, 4 up poison, 1 armor save.
3 up on the sergeant front. Oh. That 4 was just hanging out, man.
I know.
It wanted to be there.
These guys have been they've been making their saves. So now the Venom itself will shoot at the same target. Not 3. 4 ups.
So 4?
Yep.
So we're going to be... Who can you see, my friend? Just these two dudes?
I would say from the gun...
Just the 2.
Yeah, just the 2? Okay.
So 4 saves on those 2.
So 3 up, and a 3 up, and a 3 up on the guy in the back. Oh, he's dead. So,
yeah, so the 2 guys
so
are
two
gone.
Dudes smoked.
And then have to
yes, they will. Do you have any more shooting? Woo! You're going to put into them?
Let's see. Reaper shot at those, and that shot at that, and that shot at them. But successfully that finished that off. He didn't really do anything. He didn't do anything that Turbo used. Very good. And then shoot. Thank Turbo. Let's put some heat on some of this stuff.
I think that's the smart thing to do, man. Because, like, we're truthfully very close to folding. Like, Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
So that's cool. That'd be the end. Oh, wait, no. I'm sorry. One more shooting.
Swooping
Ox. I almost forgot about you.
Swooping Ox.
So they'll all shoot their shots. They've got 18 shots of those little guys. Only strength 3. Usually, you don't do too much for little lasers, but we'll see. So X Arch, normal guys. See if we do anything.
You said strength 3 on these guys, so moving on 5s?
This is good. Yeah, just making sure that dice was not hard. Didn't want to roll an extra. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 armor.
5 of them. All right, man. This is all the dudes. So 3 up armor save to start with, and another 3 up, and another 3 up, and another 3 up. Oh, one dies, and another 3 up.
So take. Doing what they're doing.
They are trying their damnedest, man.
Run after shooting 5.
And are they doing that every turn, or is that just a product of the deep strike?
They can do that every turn.
Every turn. Because like I was like, oh, I'll roll up here 6 inches and I'll go fight these guys and not have to worry about that again.
Yeah, battle focus.
Yeah,
is
not
quite,
so much.
It's quite good. So morale checks on a few of these units, Devastators.
Just the Devastators.
These guys weren't pinned, they were.
And they'll be good. Yeah, those guys got pinned coming out of the transport, so they got the white 6 next to them to signify that. These guys are going to pass their morale check and be good to go, and everybody else is solid.
So if Assault Fade is the only final thing, is this bike squad will do a little assault jump. Because they're old our jet bikes, and they've got really good. So they'll just jump back and stay out of turn. And
okay.
That'll be turn.
Cool. And we will be back at the top, bottom of turn 2. Yay! Okay, so that is all the movement. So what I did, I brought these guys, scouts on from the edge of the board. The storm wing came on, so we're going to see if we can shoot up some of these spiders right here and hold this side. We disembarked from the Razorback in the middle. Move that gray Razorback just a little bit so I can get a shot. And these guys came up so we can get a firing solution on some swooping hawks. So that's going to be everything for the movement phase. And we're just going to go straight into the stuff that's important. So the first thing I should do is make sure that whatever I'm going to shoot out of these storm talons is actually what they have. Just heavy 3. I knew that I was trying to pick up too many dice. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to do this guy right here, the close storm talon at the spiders.
This one?
This guy right here.
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
Okay, they'll jump.
Where are they going to go? Oh, I think they're gonna end up over there. Note to self, next time, pincer maneuver.
Yeah, they're kind of ridiculous, to say the least. I guess it's on difficult.
Oh man, just put them on the ground, you're solid.
Yeah, he's on terrain. Jump maneuver. These two would be like on terrain.
I like I said, if you just want to stick them down there, man, I'm cool.
So three of them are in the thick of things. I think that'll take them out of the
Okay. Yeah, that's going to take them out of firing solution there. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to shoot this Storm Raven at the Bastion. So we'll do the multi-melta first, and it'll hit on a 6, and I need something cool. Nothing. Yay! And we'll do the last cannon as well, which will twinly. Oh, it's BS5 because my storm talons are live. So it hits on a 2, and to 14, so it glance. So just one whole point. Yay! I'll take that. It's not too bad. Not too bad. So, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to shoot this plasma cannon right there, that one guy, and he's going to shoot at the middle of the Scourge. And I think I'll shoot this closest dude, and I'll be able to hit all four of them on top of it. On target, so all four. Overheats. I'm good on a 3. So there's 4 dudes inside of there. And lame, 2 guys.
I'm assuming they're getting cover from the...
Absolutely, 5 ups. So 2 dudes.
Yeah.
Okay. And so the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot. Let's see here. What do I want to do? So we'll go ahead and we will shoot. Oh, it's so scandalous. So shot with those guys. This Storm Talon is going to check range for assault cannons and be out of range. All right, so he's going to go after those. He's going to go after those Scourge.
All right, hammer away.
Yep, so here's 4 assault cannon shots. Twin linked.
Twin linked.
Wounded on 2s. 6s are going to be rending. So 2 wounds, AP4.
I'll do what I should have done before. I'll go to ground.
4 ups, 1 dude.
1 lives, 1 dies.
And here's my Skyhammer missiles. They are not twin linked, but all 3 of them will hit. They're strength 7. So 3 more wounds, AP4. So that'll get them.
So you got them.
Cool. So that's 1 for the turn. We're going to go ahead and we're going to shoot 4 las cannon shots at these spiders from the devs. Red dice is going to be my BS5 guy.
Sounds good.
And we'll hit with 3 of them.
Okay.
And we're wounded on 2s. Just a 1 guy. That could have been way, way better. So these 4 guys right here are going to rapid fire into them.
Okay.
And they're going to have 8 shots.
Okay.
And I need 3s to hit. And 3s to wound.
Oops.
Oh, 3 wounds.
All right, 3 up saves.
1 dude.
1's cooked.
So we'll go ahead and we will do this tack squad right here. What's your close combat situation look like with those spiders? T3, strength 3.
But they can hit and run. Yeah,
they can hit and run.
Yeah,
so I really need to shoot at them. I mean, especially now that they're locked down.
I mean, yeah, if you don't kill them. Right?
Yeah. So let me go ahead. I'm gonna double tap the plasma rifle into them first. So
1 overheat.
3 up. He dies, but he gets a shot off.
He does get a hit.
Which is gonna wound on a 2, which he does.
Okay, so the X-Arch is the closest. I am gonna look out, sir. I don't like that. It succeeds, so that'll boot into probably him.
Okay.
And then there are the next guy will be him.
Yeah, because I think you're gonna look out. Yep. Oh, so here's the bolter shots.
Okay.
And wounded on 3s. So 4 more.
Okay.
But 3 up armor saves, all that fun stuff.
So 2
I'll look out one of them just for the ease of this. Okay. So two will die.
Okay.
Or, I'm sorry, one will die, one will...
And the Exarch will take one. Okay. Alright, so then those snipers back there are going to fire snapshots at the spiders as well.
Okay.
And get one. And it's going to wound on a four, which it does.
A three up.
Oh, it's, oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was a precision shot.
But not anything fancy. Okay. So I'm going to plug this into the power real quick. And then we're going to move over to the other side of the table. Or not just yet. Not just yet. So, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to fire a bunch of bolter shots from these dudes.
Okay.
And they're going to shoot at the swooping hawks.
Okay.
So we're going to be rapid fire with everyone.
Sounds good.
So that's cool. We'll do the plasma rifle first.
Alright.
Ugh, overheats.
Kill yourself.
He's okay. One goes off. Does not wound. I love plasma, except for it doesn't work.
It's in theory such a good weapon.
So three, and wounded on threes. One bolt.
Nothing to kill us.
Well, that could have worked a little bit better. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. So we did plasma over there. We did all those guys. Well, the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot the Storm Bolter from this thing at this guy back here that's just kind of hanging out. See if I can get that kill off of him. So one hit. Oh, he hasn't taken a wound yet, has he? No wound. Okay, so that was a little bit less exciting than I thought. We will go ahead and we will shoot the Gone to Ground Tac Squad at the oncoming Scary Bikes. Because what else do I have to do? So we'll do that plasma rifle first. Beautiful, right?
Yeah. At least it didn't overheat.
And kill him this time. So here's going to be my eight bolter shots. I need sixes. I get one.
Fours. All right, so three up, Jinx save. He's good.
He's good. So they weather all of that shenanigans. So shot, plasma shot. Okay, these dudes over here. So, the close Razorback, that green one down on the ground, is going to shoot. Would you check rapid fire range for me for that? Yep.
Yeah.
So I'm cool. Okay, and we didn't move that one, so everything is fun.
I'm
so,
going to jump.
Okay, solid. So here's my plasma rifle shots first. It's twin linked, so they both hit. And armor value 10. So threes.
Wow. It's been
fun, yeah. Last cannon will hit and we'll pen.
Not jinx.
Go
so
through.
Wow.
Plus one.
Open top, so plus two, so it's stunned.
Some snapshots.
Yep.
Well, that could have been better Razorback. So I will go ahead and I will shoot the Tac Squad at him as well. So here come my two plasma. Well, would you still right? Okay, so here's my two plasma rifle shots. Both will hit. And sevens, so two tens. Good. All right, and a bunch of bolter shots. Still a four, I like it. And
sixes.
One glance.
So does the glance get him? No.
Nope.
Jinx it.
All right, so I think I'm gonna get a snapfire plasma rifle shot.
Absolutely, yeah, no,
and a last cannon shot. So here's my snapfire plasma, it's twin linked. Oh, I saw that six for a second. All right, last cannon, this is the important one. It hits. Oh, I certainly hope so. It pens. Roll me a two. Oh my God. Oh, it does?
Yeah,
nice. It's only a four up, I'll take it. Four plus two will be mobilized, so.
They get out. Are they pinned? No.
No.
Did the stun affect them? Because they do actually have to roll for that. No. So they're just out.
Okay. So that'll be 1-2 units, so that's not enough to get me...
The moment.
Yeah. And you have leadership on the spiders.
Spiders and I guess the scourges died.
Yeah, scourges got toasted.
So do the spiders do anything? Leadership 9, they're okay.
Yep.
Sweet.
All right, man. Yeah, that was some crazy right there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do my final reserve unit come in? They all at plus one.
Oh, of course. Why not?
Yeah, the bikes, you know, gotta have them. So, what are my choices? It's 4 and 4 left, right?
4 and 4.
Attacks over here, right?
4, 4, yeah, 5. Yeah. Yep, and there's still a attack squad inside of there. 5 guys in that attack squad, so it's getting a little thinned out. Not as many plasma guns as I would have hoped.
Yeah.
You know, to be around right now. Probably gonna be some assaulting this turn.
Yeah, these guys will. They're gonna get up in there. They're gonna try. Yeah, they're skill rider. They don't give a. They don't care about any of this. Chain effect.
Dangerous terrain.
Skilled rider.
Oh, good call.
Yeah,
you did say that, didn't you?
It's why I like the Reavers, because they confer. Skilled rider confers.
That's what's up, man.
They're just gonna walk. They actually don't really even need to. Okay,
yet. No, sir, they do not.
They could probably just come over. These guys.
That's such a mess over there, man.
There is a lot of mess over there. This could go 12. Give me something.
Oh, and for the sake of saying, man, all the aircraft are Iron Hands. Of
oh,
course.
Okay, yeah, that's good.
Sorry, I hadn't shot at them yet, but.
I'll be honest with you, I doubt that I.
I figured as much.
Yeah, like, I appreciate you.
Your priority is elsewhere.
I just don't, I mean, if I really wanted to, like, twin link stuff and shoot them, I could. I just don't really care about flyers. I don't know. It's just like.
So now, just for the sake of saying, what in your army has objective secured?
Jet bikes, warriors, and venom.
And those are the yellow guys.
Venom.
Okay. Okay,
so,
cool.
Some things, but not a lot of things.
Gotcha.
Kind of scoot this way. Or see how far they can scoot. We can go 5. We'll kind of like move over here.
Like your dice.
Thanks. I
good
like
dice.
Dice.
Yeah, and the square edges are nice.
They are, yeah.
Tried the bicycle stuff. I feel like they're a little bit too average for me.
Oh yeah.
I like dice that play into my strengths, as in roll the numbers I want them to.
Fair enough.
But yeah.
Yeah, I just hope that they give me like a relatively consistent performance. I'm happy with it.
Yeah.
I just hate rolling like completely wrong. Move through cover on these dudes.
You're going everywhere.
Yeah. Sweeping locks. What did you want to do?
I know there's lots of options.
I don't really like those guys. Really? I guess it's just really easy for them to leave the table. I'm just gonna go back this way. They can move up to the peasant, so it doesn't matter too much.
Do you have anything else in reserves right now?
No, everything's
on the board.
Everything is now on the board.
Yeah, I wish I had 7 more Razorbacks.
Yeah. It really, I mean, the Gladius is just, like, maxed out like that. It's just such a dirty, dirty.
Yeah.
Thing. You know what? They were on a terrain. 5. I can hit you.
No worries.
Okay. Alright, so let's do the good old psychic phase.
We got there.
One. Wow.
It's been a consistent year.
It has been consistent.
Let's.
Oh, wait.
Alright, let's do this. I'll throw two. I'll throw two at guide on these, this unit, just because. Well, that's not smart. I'll throw two at guide on this unit here. Goes off one.
I'm gonna let you have it.
Okay. I'll go ahead and try and cast Terrify on the Devastator. Passes on one.
It's my 6. Nope.
Alright, so they are -1 leadership and immediately take a test.
They're good.
Alright. Good devastators.
Good devastators.
So that's the end of the psychic phase. Let's do some shooting. These guys really only have them. They're going to run before shooting just to build a fleet to roll that. They just want to all get there.
Get all up in my face.
So 16 shots.
But I also feel like 5-man attack squads are way, way less resilient, obviously because they have half the wounds than a 10-man attack squad, you know? So like that's another one of the balances with the Gladius-style force.
Oh, Marines definitely, unquestionably needed something. Because no one was running mass Marines because they're not good enough compared to like a Decurion, Necron Warrior, or like all the crazy stuff in the game. But I think Gladius is a bit extreme, but so I have 6 Rems, 2, 4, 6, 7 armor saves. I assume you're going here.
Oh yeah, so here's my 6 Rens on 6 ups. I'll make 1. How many armor saves do I need?
Well, they're dead. It's 6. You failed 5 or 6 Rens, right?
Oh, I did? No, you're totally right. They're toast. I'm sorry. I thought I had enough bodies to come out.
That's okay.
Poor Space Marines.
Yeah, they got the rat.
Surprising, right?
They got the rat. Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, they don't really have the resilience.
Well, you know, in those bolters, like, it's not the same thing as having a strength 5 or a strength 6 gun.
Yeah.
You know, it's just not.
Or the Gauss, where you can lance everything. I mean, and there's no fear is a great thing. It is. Having crack grenades is fantastic. But
yep.
There's still. I'll shoot the poison shot.
Okay.
Dark Eldar is cocked. And 4 ups to wound. 3 armor saves on those brass here.
3 up. And a 3 up. And a 3 up.
We're doing okay.
We will survive. Probably all sorts of stuff.
I'm gonna shoot them out of the ashes.
Okay.
The Reapers and Bastion to get that. One second,
actually. Yeah, yeah. Reevaluating target priorities.
So yeah, I'll do that. I'll actually. So here are the guys.
This is from the Reapers inside of the Bastion.
So they all hit.
Yep.
They need 3s. So 5 AP3s, so they'll get covered.
So we'll go to ground with these guys for the 4 ups. 4 up.
2.
4 up.
3.
4 up.
4.
Oh, 1.
5.
Nope, they're all dead. Picking up Marines by the handful.
These ones will shoot at that flyer.
Okay.
They can re-roll their snapshots against the problem. So do you...
Hold on, they're re-rolling snapshots against it?
Flyers, flying monsters, creatures, and...
Just natural rule built into the unit?
It's a Reaper range. They actually ignore Jinx as well. So I was saying, do you want a Jinx, but it doesn't matter.
Okay, yeah, if it doesn't matter, then no, I don't want a Jinx, so...
Let's
see.
We got one. And they re-roll. Flyer. 3.
Nice.
Strength 5, but your armor 11, right?
Yep, so 6 is the glance.
Yeah, they don't do it.
Okay. But you know, better than nothing. Better than nothing.
They had nothing better to do with their lives. These guys against the pod.
Well, we knew this was coming.
Two is to hit. Wow.
Wowzers.
So,
The X-Arch does get a new reroll. It's going to use this reroll. He can reroll 8 dice. So he'll get a pen. The other guy...
Pen. You get a pen.
So it is open top.
Yep.
It's AP1 and fire
so plus
dragons
three.
Get another plus
four. Oh, wow. So
three,
plus four.
It'll blow.
Roll a distance, man. I hope you kill all your guys.
It'll definitely hit them. It'll definitely hit them. It'll only strength 3.
Yeah. So I thought it was strength 4 everywhere now.
I thought it was strength...
Strength 4 inside and outside.
It is outside?
Yeah, they changed it to, like, it's strength 4 just straight up.
The devil's in the details.
Yep.
And addition changes.
Absolutely.
Like, I'm still catching the money.
Me too, man. Me too. And there's, like, some stuff, like, I don't play cavalry, I don't play jet bikes. Like, there's some
the
things,
things that
yeah.
they change.
Yeah.
It's hard to remember.
So we'll do 5 on the fire dragons.
So
4.
All right. And the reapers.
So 3 on those. Just 1.
One on Dion, I guess the X-Arch takes one. I guess now we can. I do get the marks for death.
Yes, you do.
I guess it's.
Oh, losing the point battle.
This thing doesn't really have any
issue. So it's just going to. I'm just gonna sit right. This thing doesn't show either, and it doesn't have much to shoot, so it's gonna do the same. I'm just gonna make a little.
And are both of those still loaded with troops?
This one had the fire dragons in it.
Oh, they came out, okay.
Yeah,
gotcha.
I'll just sit here. So they shot scatter bikes. These bikes guided. Do they have 36? They
yep.
probably shoot those two guys.
Yeah, because I think you're tall enough to see over that intervening stuff.
I was gonna shoot the other unit, but
yeah, they died.
Reapers. Yeah, we're a little lucky.
So we're shooting
from them,
these dudes.
They get some rerolls from guide. They hit
every single die.
Which might not even matter because it can only kill two. So these are cocked. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 saves. Does it kill three guys?
Is it AP?
AP
something born. So you said how many? A million? 12? All right, we'll do here's 6.
Yeah, they're gone.
But luckily, those guys out of line of sight.
All right.
So that'll be a leadership test on them.
That's good. Warp spiders will go. We'll try and run and then shoot at the devastators. 5. Got to at least kill a few of these last cannons.
Yeah, I think you can do something.
Now, 8 shots, 2's to hit. Hit 7.
Yeah, the PS5 is excellent.
It's very, very strong. So 6 saves, 1 rend. You can take the rend first.
So we got 2 last cannons. One of them will survive. So that'll be...
And then
4 more. So he's toast. We'll do that last cannon on a 3, and another 3, and 2 more saves on a 3, and another 3. So 2 last cannons down. Death pile.
I'll go ahead and hawks into the scouts. Why not? Not very good rolls here.
I was about to say, that's what I need, except for everyone's PS5.
Yeah, Hawks are, so that's good. So 4.
4?
4 wins.
So 4 up saves. Let's do it. So there's a 4, and a 2, and a 2, and a 6. So that's 2 guys.
And I'll run after shooting with the Hawks. 2, fleet it, 6. This comes so that's cool. Shot with them. Shot with them. I don't really really good shot at them. They didn't shoot great points here. They're just going to turbo boost over to here.
It's nice when you don't have to worry about doing real work. You just fly around the battlefield.
Yeah, well,
chilling.
You know, they're valuable enough that they gotta stay alive, I guess.
So I think that's all the shooting I have.
So leadership.
Yes.
They're gonna be good on a three. Last cannon squad. He's going to be good on an eight. And I think that that is all of my... Scouts.
Yeah.
I think they're an eight as well, but it's not going to matter. So, solid. Okay, leadership.
Close combat, I'm going to assault primary, secondary.
Okay.
You cannot overwatch due to Banshee Mask.
Well, that's that then, huh?
Yeah, kind of an annoying thing. So bikes, five, it will definitely get to them. I'm going to fleet... seven.
Yeah.
So even with actually it doesn't even matter. There.
Well, hold on, because like if any of your units, but you have skilled riders, so you ignore difficult. So
yes.
Solid.
Yeah.
Yep.
So they're okay.
All over the place. Well, that's going to be. Yeah. We're not ready for the violence with which the Eldar showed up today.
Okay. So a Hammer of Wrath attacks, a Strength 4 Rending Hammer on the Plasma Cannon Squad, nothing. The Cluster Caltrops, they get D6, Strength 6 ones each, so they're going to get 12, wow.
That's pretty much that then. You didn't. If I wasn't pointing the camera at the right thing, you had D6, Hammer of Wrath attacks, Rending.
So one will straight up die. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 saves on the Marines.
Jeez, so here's my first five. They will all make it.
Marines have been saving all right, though.
And here's my next one. It's three more deaths.
So then, only one left.
Couldn't hold out.
And then the other three Strength 4 hammers that are rending. One more save for the Marines. Regular Marine unit.
Good.
Okay, so... initiative, pile in at I-6. Just pile in. So, we'll throw the Autarchs, five attacks at the what's it called, Plasma Cannon deck.
Yep.
So he needs threes to hit. Hits three. Strength 6, he needs two swooned, so they're dead.
Just AP three.
The normal guys, they get... three per.
Oh, we're still alive over there? Okay.
You've got one.
I mean, you'd probably
yeah, the...
Here's the 15.
Yeah.
Throws from them.
Jesus.
And they'll need...
fours?
They'll need fives.
Okay.
So three. Three all right. On.
All right, buddy. Come on, you can do this. No, you can't.
It'll be
no,
enough.
No, you can't. That'll be enough.
So he's cooked.
Yes, he is.
So, in there. So consolidate on my unit. Six.
Ugh. So that's the middle of the field, man. That's the whole thing. So it looks like we got a bunch of stuff out here, but we really don't.
Shuffle like that, and that'll be that. So that was top of three.
Yep. So, progressive objectives. I have 1 point, and we will definitely be out of range there. I don't think I'm going to be in range to get these from objective secured, so I will not. So
you have
1 point. So no score at all off of 1 point. You got to have at least three. Okay. Yeah, well, that's that, isn't it? Isn't it? Okay, so we're going to go ahead. I'm going to do my movement and set down this camera, and I'll be right back after I figure out how to do the best job I can not getting massacred just this turn. All right, so we moved a little bit. I shuffled the command squad over here because I really don't think there's too much I can do other than hold this objective and wait for some evac. Storm Raven's coming back around, and we're going to shoot with the stuff that we have left and see if the game ends and what the points are at and all that good stuff. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot just a single plasma rifle shot at this guy, so we're going to jank. And this is from the TAC squad. It hits, and it will pen. and you will be jinked. So, well played, sir, well played. There's not really any firing solutions over here because it's all 12-inch range guns, so they're just going to hang out where they are. And the only other thing I can do is I'm going to fire a twin-link las cannon shot at this X-Arch right there.
Go for it.
That guy right there. And I'm going to hit him on a 5, and I will wound him on a 6. And he will be fine.
All right.
Well okay. done, sir.
Yeah, he's killing.
That's all I got, man. That's all my models. All
right.
You would you like to, you want to roll this one? I did the last one. It'll be a 1, right. And that'll be game.
Good game.
Good game, man. That was fun.
For sure.
So we're gonna pause for a second. We're gonna tally up the points. You know, I'm holding this middle objective, man. But the Eldar are everywhere. The Eldar are clearly in command of this board. There's no shenanigans about it. Everything has been destroyed. We're gonna come back with more Razorbacks and a Land Raider next time. See how that works. Points shortly.